Hey everyone, Bridget from Money After Graduation here to talk to you about my favorite retirement saving strategy, and that is Coast Fire. Now, if you've never heard of Coast Fire before, you're gonna love it because this is the best fire retirement strategy that is available because it's excellent for lazy people. Well, I'm kidding about that. You shouldn't call yourself lazy, but it is the best solution for people who want to optimize their finances and financial security while still enjoying the rest of their life, which is me. I'm one of those people, and I think you probably are too. So what is Coast Fire? Well, Coast Fire, it's Coast, and then that acronym, Financial Independence, Retire Early, which normally is too extreme of a retirement strategy for me, but when you put the Coast in there, it literally means you can coast to financial independence and early retirement. Coast Fire is a retirement strategy where you amass an amount of savings and investments early in life that even if you don't add another dime to that balance, forevermore for the rest of your working lifetime, it will still grow to enough for you to comfortably retire on. And if you're in your 20s or early 30s, you might be surprised by how low that number actually is. Now, that's not to say that it's easy to achieve Coast Fire, because it's not. This is still an aggressive retirement saving strategy, but the rewards are huge. Just imagine what it would feel like to hit your Coast Fire number in your late 20s or early 30s and know that your retirement is taken care of even if you never add another dime. That is financial security and financial peace of mind that just feels incredible. And it's a really manageable one. It's way easier than traditional FIRE or lean FIRE, where you have to live very frugally in order to amass hundreds of thousands or even $1 million before you can leave the workforce. Coast Fire, depending where you're starting, can be as low as a five-figure sum. So it's way more attainable and it's way less painful to get to. To find your Coast Fire number, essentially what you want to think about is what you want your retirement portfolio to be when you leave the workforce and work backwards from there. For most people, this will be a number between $1 and $3 million. So if you need a $1, $2, or $3 million portfolio when you're age 65 or age 67, what amount do you need to have in savings and investments to ensure that they grow at the regular rate that the stock market return is in order to reach that target 1 to 3 million at age 67? Now, you can see that starting young really is your biggest asset here. You don't need a large amount to hit that kind of total if you're beginning at age 25 or 29 or even 35. However, if you're in your 40s, 50s, or 60s, you might be getting past Coast Fire, or at least it will be quite a bit harder in order to achieve this. So let's say, for example, you're 25 years old and you want to retire at age 65 with $1 million. Your Coast Fire number is actually only $46,000, assuming you can consistently get at least an 8% annual return in the stock market. Now, that's totally reasonable. Historically, the stock market returns about 10%, so 8% is a little bit of a lowball, or it can account for inflation. In any case, if you can manage to get $46,000 in your savings and investments by age 25, even if you add no extra money for the rest of your working lifetime, you'll still have a $1 million portfolio at age 65. Now, if you're 30 years old, some more time has passed, so you have to do some catching up, but it's still a very manageable $67,000. Wait until 35 and you're getting close to $100,000 needed in your investment portfolio in order to hit that 1 million target by age 65. Now, your Coast Fire number might be different depending on what age you want to retire and what return you can expect to get in the stock market. But nevertheless, there is a figure that you can maybe use to plan your retirement strategy over your working lifetime. And the sooner that you start, the better off you'll be financially, because it's really easy to add a little bit more to our retirement portfolios, or maybe take a break if we need to because other things are going on in our lives, knowing that we have enough in there no matter what happens. Now, undoubtedly at this point, someone always asks me about inflation. What about inflation? What about inflation? I don't understand Coast Fire and inflation. Well, it's really easy to understand Coast Fire and inflation, because essentially how inflation works is it doesn't depress the value of your retirement portfolio. It just changes the buying power of the dollars in there. So all these numbers and calculations still work. You can get to 1 million from an 8% return starting with this amount at age 25 or 35. However, what inflation says is that 1 million will actually have less buying power at the time of your retirement. Now, this is okay. This is normal. Inflation is just a thing that happens. And the way to counteract inflation or defend against it is simply to save more money. So when you're calculating your Coast FIRE number, you're only doing it to get the calculations. A certain amount will grow to $1 million over a certain amount of time at a certain return. That is true. That's just math. What that buying power of that $1 million will have in the future is a little bit unpredictable. I don't know what the rate of inflation is going to be over the next 20 or 30 years. Generally, estimates are between 2% and 3% per year, but not everything inflates at the same rate. Sometimes housing goes up faster than food and services, so it's really hard to say. Inflation, especially over the long term, is harder to predict, but the math of your portfolio always works out. If you're concerned about inflation, please just save more for retirement. If you've done the math and you're way behind your Coast FIRE number, please don't worry. You don't have to hit Coast FIRE by age 25 or age 28 in order for it to work. You can just figure out what your Coast FIRE number is and work towards it. Like I said, this is an aggressive saving strategy, and that means that it does take a little bit extra work than if you were just to save consistently over your working lifetime. However, the benefits are huge, so I want to encourage you to save as much as you can when you're young in order to hit Coast FIRE if it's possible, or even just to get ahead on your retirement contributions when you can afford to do so. Remember, the most important thing about money is that it gives you choices. We want it to give us freedom and options now and in the future, and having more of it is the best way to do that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and learned a little bit more about Coast FIRE today. If you have any questions, please leave them below in the comments and I will be happy to answer them. I'll also link my blog post on Coast FIRES, which goes into a little bit more detail with graphs and charts so you can get a better idea of what your Coast FIRE number is and how to calculate it. Other than that, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and I will see you next week.